Blessed morning, blessed morning. Blessed morning. I hope I got it right this time. Glory be to God. Come on in, come on in. Give everybody a moment to log back on. I do apologize for coming on and having to get off. I want to come on from the ministry's page. Please tag and share and invite. Good morning, Sister Carla. Good morning. God bless you. Blessed morning, blessed morning. What a wonderful day it is. In the name of Jesus, just to be in the presence of the Lord. Please share, tag, invite. Blessed morning, Denise. Sister Denise, blessed morning. God bless you. God bless you, Sister Ruby. God bless you. Thank you for joining. We're going to exalt the Lord this morning. We're going to lift him high. He's the King of Heaven. Let him be glorified this morning. Amen. It says that all creations, we should all testify. Oh, the word says, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. So we're going to praise the Lord this morning. We're going to give him his first fruits this morning. We thank the Lord this morning for who he is. Give me 1 second. I pray everyone has had a wonderful weekend. We cry out holy. He is the Lord God Almighty. He is a strong tower. He is a mighty fortress. The song says, isn't he beautiful? All his creations are beautiful. You are his creation. So there's much praise and thanks that should be given this morning. So we just thank you this morning. Thank you this morning for joining. We thank you. As you come in, tag, share, and like. Tag, share, and like. We thank the Lord this morning because everything that he does is wonderful. give a couple of more people time to get on this morning. I know this time has really shifted us, but we must shift in all things, right? So we're trying to get readjusted. But we do thank the Lord this morning for those of you who are coming on this morning. Yes, He is worthy to be praised. God is worthy to be praised. There should always be a continuous praise in our mouths. Don't let a rock cry out in your place. When you think of the goodness of the Lord, you just think of everything that's beautiful, right? It's just amazing of when we could just look at the creations, when we look at the trees, when we look at the ocean, when we look at just nature itself, to see something so beautiful, and just to know that our God, our Father, created something so beautiful, something that man cannot do. So we must continuously give God praise for all the things that He has done. I know everyone is getting ready for work or already at work, but I do thank you this morning for getting on, not taking it as robbery, to get on and praise the Lord this morning. Today is Fresh Manna Monday. Today we're going to talk about commanding your atmosphere. Come on in. There you come on in. Sharing like. Blessed morning, Stephanie. Blessed morning, my beautiful cousin. Blessed morning. Thank you for joining. God is good, y'all. God is good. When I think of the goodness of the Lord, there's just something that just builds up on the inside of me. Just thinking about where He has brought us from. And where He is about to take us when we have expectation in Him. But the word says, for I know the thoughts that I have towards you. And they are to prosper you, to give you a hope and a future. They are not for evil, the Lord says. And I'm paraphrasing this morning. But we bless you all this morning. God bless you for joining. Just know that you are not ordinary. The Lord is not ordinary. He's extraordinary, people. He's extraordinary. Like the song says, isn't He beautiful? God bless you, Pastor. Thank you for joining this morning. God bless you, Auntie Shelley. Thank you for joining. God is no ordinary man. That's why we should give Him the most respect, the utmost respect in all we do. Giving Him praise, giving Him your first fruits, giving Him your undivided attention. It's time that we get into the presence of the Lord. Amen, amen, amen. I won't be before you long this morning, but I just want to come on this morning and give you a fresh word, fresh manna Monday. You know, the Lord places things on the inside of us, and sometimes if we don't bring out what the Lord has put in, how can He continuously fill us with more? You know, we have to, you know, release when it's time to release. But we must continuously pour out so the Lord can pour back in. Amen. So I just thank the Lord this morning for what He's doing in this season and this hour. Give all glory and honor to God this morning. We bless His holy name. We enter His gates with thanksgiving and His outer courts with praise. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. This morning, I'm just going to talk about, you know, just commanding your atmosphere. Like I said, I'm not going to be before you long. We have to get in the mind frame of when we wake up in the morning, what we have on the inside, what we know that we need to accomplish, what we want to see accomplished, we have to start speaking those things that are not as though they were, as the word would say. The word of God says we have to command our days. Just, I like to say we have to do climate control. Just when you get up in the morning or in the evening, whatever time of day it is, when you go to set your thermostat in your house to a certain temperature, you're commanding your atmosphere. You're setting your atmosphere to the adjustment that you want to see it at. So that's what we have to do as people of God. We have to set the atmosphere as to what we want to see it as. God has given us that authority. He has given us that right. That's when your faith kicks in. Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So we have to hope for and just have the faith, knowing that God is going to do just what we've asked. Amen. We have to trust and believe. We have to trust and believe in God. At all times, no matter how the situation may seem, no matter what it may look like, when you are anchored in the Lord and unshakable, unmovable in your faith, you can move mountains. He said, if we have faith the size of a mustard seed, we can do it. We could do marvelous things. But we just have to believe that what we pray about, we know that it's going to come to fruition. God is not a man that he shall lie, nor the son of man that he shall repent. When he hears your prayers, his answers are yes and amen. They may not come when we want them to, but they will always be right on time. Always remember that the Lord does things in his timing. His timing, he will not give you nothing out of order, because he is a God of excellency. He does things decent and in order. So we must remember that this morning. I thank God this morning for that. And I'm just trying to... I was reading something this morning and I just wanted to share it. And it was just talking about how when the Lord was in the wilderness and he was tempted, Jesus stood his ground because he knew the Father that he had, the King that he serves. Amen. And that's what we have to get in the mind frame of knowing, that when we know whose we are, who we are, and who we serve, all else don't matter. We can't worry about what people think about us. The Bible tells you that's a sin. You shouldn't worry about what people think about you. You should worry about what God thinks about you. When we get that under control, then we can move in where God has called us to move. But too many times we're just worried about what somebody else is saying, what somebody else is thinking, and what, you know, why would this person do that? No. We focus on the wrong things. We focus too much on the wrong things. Your only obligation in any lifetime is to be true to yourself and be truthful with God. He knows who you are. He created you. So he know all about you. He wants you to know all about you. We don't know who we are. And we get lost because we try to, you know, blend in and, you know, compromise. But we know what the word of the Lord says. We're not supposed to compromise for anything or anyone. We're supposed to be a God pleaser, not a people pleaser. Amen. You know, the Bible says that Jesus was tested by the evil one for 40 days and 40 nights. The number 40 is typically symbolic of a time of testing, trial, and purification and renewal. The other thing that I like about, you know, when we're going into Lent, it reminds us that no matter what we're facing, every battle is temporary. Amen. Every battle is temporary. And as my grandmother used to say, every storm runs out of rain. Eventually, the storm will stop. It will pass over, as the song says. The storm is passing over now. And sometimes I have to keep reminding myself of that when I face opposition or different things come about. You know, the storm, I have to say, you know, this storm is going to pass. And this too shall pass. Amen. But the most difficult things about trials and tribulations is that they can seem to go on forever. But if it's not one thing, it's another. Trust me. You know, and I posted last night, you know, when we are facing opposition, you know, we think, you know, that it's all like, Lord, where's all this coming from? But the Lord said that, you know, adversities would come. So when we know his word, we know what to expect. It shouldn't take us by surprise. But sometimes when we, you know, are out of the alignment of God and what he is doing, some things will just try to overtake us. But when we stand our ground and know, and we can command our atmosphere and our climate, do climate control, and knowing that what we have going on, that God can do exceedingly and abundant and above all that we could think or imagine to bring us out. Amen. But today the word of God says, for everything there is a season. More than ever, it is important for you to maintain a godly perspective on the issue you are going through. That's right. We don't stand, you know, we don't shake, we shift. We won't give up. We won't give up. We won't give up. You know, this is the season, I believe. This is the season that God is doing a new thing. I'm seeing the Lord has just been blowing my mind. He's been doing things. We've been praying. We've been fasting. We are seeing the hand of God move. And we have to get in alignment to what God is doing, because if we don't, we will certainly miss it. I spoke about windows of opportunity last week. You know, there's always a window of opportunity. Just like the woman with the issue of blood, she pressed her way through. That was a window of opportunity. So we have to make sure that we don't miss what God is doing in this season. Amen. You know, we have to focus and think on the things and all the ways that God has blessed you. When you think on the goodness of the things that God has blessed you, you will continuously trust and believe that, you know, he will continue to pull you out, pull you through to do those things. He said, the word says we should think of the things that are above. We have to think of things that are above. We have to come, Lord says, come up hither. We have to stay up there. We got to, oh, good. Blessed morning, my sister. Thank you for joining this morning. Thank you. But there is no God like our God. There's no Father like our Father. He's unfailing. He's forever loving. He will give you strength when you are weak. We just got to continuously seek after him. Seek after him and just to be in his presence. Excuse me. You know, I have seen God heal, deliver, save, and restore. We all are living, walking miracles and testimonies of the goodness and the greatness and the marvelous works of God. I'm just here to testify. If it not have been for the Lord who was on my side. There's joy when I think of the goodness of the Lord. and my, you know, the song "You Are My Strength" by William Murphy. You know, that song, the Lord is our strength. He gives us everything that we need. You know, I know there are many people who feel weak, that your strength has been lost, but keep holding on to God, because God will never let you go, no matter what you are facing, no matter how big your giant seems. We serve a God who will defeat every foe and every enemy. He said he will be an adversary to our adversaries, an enemy to our enemies. He has your back. He has your back. That's why I always tell people, I'm like, yeah, I got my boys rocking with me. They got my back. Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. They will never lead me or guide me astray. Amen. Glory be to God. I just thank you for coming on this morning. If you haven't tagged, shared, liked, please do so. Yes, sister. Yes. He's a strength like no other, and it reaches to me. Amen. 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 And that's the mind frame that we should always be in. That's why it's so important that we get in and study and just read the Word of God. Because when we read His Word resonates on the inside of us. It's deeply rooted in us. Then we know how we should maneuver. We know what things we should do. And it's just a blessing. I have someone who wants to join us this morning.
Blessed morning. Blessed morning. Blessed morning, everyone. God bless you. We thank you for joining. I'm busy doing some things, so I can't physically be on for the morning encouragement. But I pray that you all are having a wonderful and very blessed day. And I just want to share real quickly that the Bible says, you have not because you ask not. And sometimes we don't ask, so therefore we don't receive. It says, so as the Lord is doing a new thing, the vision of 2021 is the Lord is doing a new thing. God is about to blow our minds. We have to learn how to position ourselves in decreeing and declaring the things that we're seeking from the Lord to do. We also have to ask for things. And one of the things that I have been struggling with, and I'm saying I have been because I'm moving past that, is asking people to sow. And the Lord had to rebuke me, and Bishop mentioned that he used to encounter the same problem. But when we don't give people the opportunity to sow on fertile ground, we prohibit your growth. We prohibit you from putting seeds in fertile ground that will reap your harvest. So I am coming out of a mindset and a mind frame that, you know, asking people to sow is so complicated. So if you notice, I have been putting in the comments, if you would like to sow, and the ways to sow, because there are things that the kingdom of God needs in order to progress. So we thank each and every one of you, and I'm going to slide back over to my space. But I just want to encourage you to ask. The only thing someone can tell you is no. But I will not put myself in a position to block anyone's blessings, because I have a, I'm not going to say a fear, but more so a complex, because I know that people have issues with giving. You see a lot of people posting down their timelines about giving. I actually saw someone who said, pastors, please don't ask us to give our 10% from our stimulus, because it says give 10% of your, I think it says earnings, and we didn't earn this, it was given. So, you know, people, there is a spirit that hovers over the giving.
That is true.
And it's called the Tobias spirit, and I was researching that. And I want to encourage you that giving is not in a sense of having hundreds or thousands of dollars. If you have $2, $5, you know, sow seeds in fertile ground. Understanding that in order to give to people, in order to help people, which are things that we do when people are in need, we help them. We give to them, sometimes sacrificially, things in order for us to do things. It costs. So it's not that we're trying to, you know, come up. I mean, we have our own job, so we're not trying to come up off of anyone's money. But I'm stepping out of a season of hindering anyone from what God has to do for them. So if I ask you to sow and you have it, just sow. If I ask you to sow and you ain't got it, just in the name of Jesus, I'll be able to sow in the future. But in order for us to come out of a place of where we are, we have to sow. And as a person that has been sowing, I believe in the year 2020, as the pandemic hit, I sowed just from, you know, what I received in receipts. And I didn't get all my receipts, probably not even half of them. I sold more in that 1 year than I probably have done ever. And, well, I know I have. So I didn't come on here to talk about money. I came on here to talk about your blessings and your harvest. We have to labor, people of God, and I'm learning that I cannot be uncomfortable because of what the people are going to feel. I have to say, God, I'm going to do what you ask and required of me. So if you have it to give and you can give, I have put in the comments the ways to give. The website allows any credit card payments. You know, a lot of people use Cash App. Send Cash App. And blessings to you, Pastor Ollie, for your seed this morning. God bless you, Pastor. And for anyone who's sowing, I always pray and I try to respond to everyone by message when you sow, because I want the Lord to bless you in abundance and overflow. And I thank you all. And again, I'm working and I'm busy. I've been up here since 6, and I just pray that you all have a blessed and wonderful day, and that you continue to seek God, because without God, your world is in trouble. And with God, you can do all things. The scripture says we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. So God bless you, people of God. I know I'm over here in the background, but it's okay. I can be in the background.
Isn't she beautiful?
Not this morning. I'm a little rough and ragged, but God bless you. You know, sometimes I have to get made up to be on Facebook, but I don't need to be made up to do the will of the Lord. I just need to be in the Spirit of God, allowing the Holy Spirit to usher me. A lot of times people get so confused nowadays that, you know, the first lady, or, you know, you got to have on all this makeup and your hair got to be like this. And I don't need all that. Listen, when I'm in church, ask Minister Sean. The first thing I say is, y'all sitting in this congregation being cute. I ain't come to be cute. I came to give God an ugly praise.
Amen.
So, you know, we have to come out of the stereotype of what man desires for us. And learn how to worship and usher the Lord by the Spirit of God. So God bless you, each and every one of you. Have a wonderful and very blessed day. And I'm going to slide back over to my space over here. And I'm praying for you all. God bless you. And we kingdom, baby. I just thought I'd say that. God bless you.
Amen. I knew that was coming. God bless you, woman of God. God bless you. Yeah, so we just thank the Lord this morning because, like Pastor said, even in the middle of the pandemic, we have been sowing and pouring in, and we're just reaping the benefits of what God is doing. And there are some testimonies that we have been receiving, you know, for some people who we've been praying for, who's been sowing. And, you know, they've been sowing what the Lord has placed on their hearts to sow. And it's, you know, the obedience is better than the sacrifice. But the Lord sees our sacrifice when we sow sacrificially. I mean, he knows our hearts. He knows what we are in need of. So only he can provide those things to us. He is just using Pastor and myself as living, willing vessels to get the message out to the people of God. Because when, like I said before, when the Lord gives us something, it's for us to release it. And in order for us to keep, you know, being replenished, we have to continuously do just what the Lord says. We have to pour in so that, you know, pour out so the Lord can pour back into us. And that goes the same for you. When you pour out, the Lord will pour back into you. He will replenish you. He will give you what you need. It's biblical principle. And sometimes we look at the millionaires and the billionaires and we don't understand that some of them had no education. And how are they doing all these things? It's because they're doing biblical principles, and, you know, they're being cheerful givers. The Lord said he loves a cheerful giver. Amen. So we just thank the Lord this morning for that. And like for some, it is a touchy subject because, you know, many have been, you know, bamboozled and, you know, I'm just going to say, you know, but it's, but I understand, but we understand, you know, but we just have to trust in the Lord, knowing that what he says is going to, you know, come to fruition. We have to just continuously trust him when we can't even trace him. Amen. So I thank you all this morning for coming on this morning. I pray that, you know, the morning encouragement has been a blessing to you. I know that we have to get, you know, everyone has to get to work this morning and, you know, continue our days. Give me 1 second. I have it here. Sorry about that. Before we depart, you know, we like to say our morning affirmations, our morning sayings. Amen. So I thank you all for those who have sowed. The kingdom of God truly appreciates it because, like Pastor said, what we do, you know, for the ministry and what we do to help the people of God, you know, the Lord is blessing. You know, it's nothing that, you know, we do for the benefit of ourselves. No, it's all for the benefit and for the glory of God. Amen. And that's when we have that mindset. We should definitely have a mindset in glorifying God. Whatever we do, we should make sure we're doing it pleasing and acceptable unto God. Amen. So who's him? H-I-M-M. He is molding me, Jesus. We pray. We're hashtagging. We're addicted to Jesus. We about that Jesus life. Stay ready so you don't have to get ready. Be prepared. You never know when the Lord's going to call you to do something. You know, you might just be put on the spot. But we chucking up the deuces, you know, to Satan. We tell him he got to pack his bags, he got to go. You know, we shall have peace. Amen. We're not scared. We don't give up. You know, the Lord don't give us the spirit of fear, you know, but love, power, and of sound mind. You know, we tell Satan he got to pack his bags, he got to go, y'all. You know, he has been defeated. The devil is defeated and God has been exalted. Amen. Amen. Who's bad? I like to say this. Who's bad? I'm bad. We bad. We blessed and delivered. Hear that? We blessed and delivered. That's not how the song says. Some bad mama jammers. Glory to God. But we blessed and delivered. Praise God. We rocking with the best. J-E-S-U-S. We play. What? They play checkers, we play chess, because we're strategic in how we serve the Lord. The Lord does things strategically. Remember that he's strategic in all that he does. Tighten up, strap up, put on the full armor of God. We got to keep it on, people of God. We got to always be ready. We live a life of prosperity. We are restored. Pump your brakes. The race is not given to the swift nor to the strong, but to the one who endures to the end. Stay in your lane. Stay in your lanes. It's not a race. Just pump your brakes. Slow down. Do what you got to do. Do what you got to do. The Lord sees you. Use us, Lord, for your glory is what we should always ask him. Lord, use me for your glory. Bless me so I can be a blessing to others. That's always been my prayer. Lord, bless me so I can be a blessing to others. Amen. You cannot be healed from what you do not reveal. You know, stop being extra. This pastor's favorite, stop being extra. You know, we all have a little extra on the inside of us. But guess what? Because we're extraordinary. So sometimes it's okay. Amen. But you are what you answer to. Stop being called anything other than what God calls you. You are a child of the Most High. You are more than a conqueror. You are the head and not the tail. You are a lender and not a borrower. You are the heir to the throne. You are a kingdom ambassador. Set your atmosphere, set the tone. Speak those things that are not as though they were. Amen. We don't shake, we shift. Be unshakable in your faith. Stand firm on God's word, the solid rock. Don't say it, just pray about it. We are first responders in prayer. We are the essential workers in the kingdom of God. Amen. Glory to God. And we thank the Lord for the essential workers and the healthcare profession and all that they do, the first responders, because, you know, that job is not easy and it's not for everyone. So I thank the Lord for them, and I continuously pray for them as well. Amen. Glory be to God. We pray together. We praise together. We kingdom for life. We don't compromise. We don't compromise. Never compromise who you are in Christ for anything or anyone. Amen. Trust God when you can't trace him. We will not bow to anything other than God. Any other thing that tries to exalt itself, got to go. Whatever it is that's trying to overtake you, just trying to get your attention more than, you know, what you're giving to God, it has to go. It's a distraction. Amen. Trust God. Just trust him. We're not living in a pandemic. We're living in a shiftemic. The Lord is shifting some things around. The Lord is doing some great and marvelous things. You know, we have to stay in posture of prayer. Pray without ceasing. You must stay in your lane. Like I said before, stay in your lane. This is not a race. Just do what God has called you to do. Be pleasing unto him. No one else. No one else. Everyone has their own purposes. We are here to encourage one another. Iron sharpens iron. Amen. And Pastor had already said it, but, you know, we're going to say it again. We kingdom, baby. We kingdom for life. We have a kingdom mentality. Amen. And when we keep that mindset that we are kingdom, we know that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Amen. But we know the scripture says, for all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord and who are called according to his purpose. So I thank you this morning for jumping on this morning, for joining us on the Morning Encouragement, you know, a fresh man on Monday. We pray that you all have a blessed and wonderful work week. We pray that the Lord will give you your heart's desires, everything that you have been praying for, as long as it's aligning up according to the will of God. We stand in the prayer with you on that. We know that the Lord says we must stand in the gap. You know, we must intercede for others. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Sister Denise. Thank you, Sister Denise. She says, thanks, Team Wheelers. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, Auntie Shelley. Thank you again. And God bless each and every one of you for coming on this morning. Please share, tag, invite. Someone might need to hear this. And like I said, there are many testimonies coming forward. I, too, you know, have a testimony. And just I can share this before I jump off. There, by me sowing, and I know that the Lord is doing this, because when we sow in a pandemic, the Lord will certainly, you know, give us what we need. I've been sowing, and there was some things, I shared this with a couple of people before, there were some things that was on my credit report that, you know, that needed to come off. But, you know, I was speaking about windows of opportunity. And I had missed the window of opportunity a while back because I received a letter in the mail and I missed the time frame that was allowed for me to settle the debt. And they were going to settle it at a great price. And I just prayed to the Lord, because we are trying to do some things and move forward in what the Lord has told us to do. And, you know, we need some things just come off our credit. You need your credit to be good. And I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, and I prayed, I said, I just need this thing to come around again. I need it. I need an opportunity for them to offer me something so I can pay it and it can be wiped off my credit. And when I tell you, after I prayed no later than 2 weeks, I found a letter that I got out of my post office box, and it was a letter again, I would say after almost 2 years, to settle this debt. I just thank the Lord for what he is doing and for answering prayers. Because he is faithful. He is faithful. Amen. And I just wanted to share that this morning, because my window of opportunity came around again. But we must be alert that when the window of opportunity comes around the first time, we need to make sure that we are alert. Amen. God bless you all. We love you all. And have a wonderful and marvelous and glorious week. Be blessed.